Hey beautiful souls, welcome to my channel. If you're new to my channel, we are covering the 12 zodiac signs, and today we are discussing the zodiac sign Capricorn. Capricorn is the 10th zodiac sign amongst the 12 zodiac signs in the calendar. And before I proceed, I want to share with you a very important fact that the planets under which we are born, they hold a very significant value in our life. It influences us both physically as well as psychologically. So our existence and our status totally depend upon the planetary motions, their placements, their changes, and the impact of that particular planet on the particular zodiac sign. So the way, the kind of education we pursue, the thoughts we have, the opinions we share, the functioning of our brain, of our cell, the friends we have, even the spouse and the children, the destiny is predestined, okay? It's already been decided. The day, the second, or the precisely the moment you are born and the moment you will die is already decided. So if you ask me, like, okay, if everything is decided, then why do we need to like struggle so much? Why there is so much of entangling in life? That is because that is the rule of the nature, you know. You just can't sit and wait for things to happen. You have to proceed towards them. You have to work for them. And you know, like, if you are destined to be a billionaire and if you just wait billions to come into your account, that is not the way. You will turn a billionaire, but in the life when you will work towards becoming a billionaire. So that thing you have to understand very clearly. So Capricorns, let's begin. If you are born between 22nd of December to 19th of January, your zodiac sign is Capricorn. And this is the symbol which I chose for Capricorns because I find it simple and clear. Okay, so this is the symbol for Capricorn. Otherwise, there's a sheep with two horns like that. Okay, and can you see here in red, I utilize. I utilize is the voice of your soul. A Capricorn soul always say, I utilize what I have. I utilize the resources. I utilize the things around me. I utilize my life. So I use what I have. That is the voice of your soul. Your soul voice is I utilize. If we have to discuss the lucky numbers for you, they are 5, 10, 16, 22, 26, 35 and 43. The rest numbers are also lucky, but comparatively these numbers will yield you quick results. They will stop the delays. Okay, the pending works will be completed on time, on schedule. And if you ask me what are my lucky colors, I say all colors are lucky for all the zodiac signs, because the color, different colors, you know, white, violet, yellow, orange, red, blue, green, every color will, each color is scattering from the single white light. When the white light falls on a physical object, the object will reflect the light back. You know, it will absorb certain light. The light which is it absorbs is its color. Okay, so all colors are lucky. I don't believe in the theory of colors being unlucky, because all colors are beautiful, vibrant, exuberant, and they reflect different auras. So all colors are lucky for all the zodiac signs. And you know, like, you spend so much of money and time wondering about your horoscope, like what are your planetary positions and what you should do, what you should not do, what you should wear, what you should not wear, which color suits you, which, so you know, these things, the universal forces always guide us. Like, like, for example, your lucky gemstone is the neelam, we say it in Hindi, and I don't know what we call it in English. It is blue sapphire. Yes, the blue sapphire is your lucky gemstone. You don't know that your zodiac sign is Capricorn, your lucky gemstone is blue sapphire, but you are drawn towards blue sapphire if you have to buy jewelry or if you like somebody else wearing jewelry. And whenever you start a good venture, the combination of the numbers will be automatically like 5, 10, 16, 20, 26, 35 and 43. So all the planetary forces, the magnetic energies and your spirit guides and your ancestral spirits and your karma, it will make you drawn towards what you are luckier for. Okay, it's only that difference is that few people are very, very receptive. They understand the messages from the non-physical forces, but few people are not. So you have to just turn yourself receptive, and that will also happen when the correct time comes. But still, one thing what you can do is you can surrender yourself to the good vibes, to the positive vibes, and nothing negative will happen to you. Okay, so it's just, you know, it gives you a vision. Why do you want to come to a tarot reading? Why do you want to go to a horoscope? Why do you want to know about your zodiac signs, your lucky colors and lucky numbers and gemstones and what will happen in your future? You can do nothing even if you know your future, because what has to happen will happen, but the impact can be withdrawn a little bit, you know. That's the only thing, and it will give you a clearer vision. Like, if you think that you want to be a writer, and but you pursue a study of business management, but your heart throttles for ask you to write stories, write poems. So when you are in the crossroads of your life, maybe it's your career or it's your relationship, your heart says you one thing, but your brain is not ready to accept it. So when you come through channels like me, then you will get a clear vision, because your zodiac sign is telling you that you can become this. These are the options, best options for you to choose from. So it will give you just a vision. It will give you just a hope when you are nothing around, everything around you turns dark. So the tarot reading will give you a vision. It will give you a hope. It will give you an insight. Okay. So Capricorns are ruled by the planet Saturn. Yes. Shani. In Hindi it is called Shani, and in English it is Saturn. So Capricorns are ruled by planet Saturn, and Saturn is a very, very isolated planet. You know, it has got rings around it. It has got protection around it. So and it's a blue planet. Okay, the blue gases are persistent in Saturn. So Capricorns are connected to Saturn, and Saturn is connected to the blue sapphire. So your lucky gemstone is blue sapphire. And let me again tell you one more theory, which is very, very scientific. That is about the gemstone. If you don't believe in the power of the gemstone, you trust it is pure science, and it is absolutely pure science, and there is no question of doubt, because Saturn is made up of some certain chemicals and certain dust particles. Your body is also a complex chemical factory, and the gemstones are also the chemical combinations which are being extracted from deep crusts of earth. Okay, so this gemstone, the blue sapphire, when worn by Capricorn touching their skin, it will give you a complete wholeness. It will give you it will retain the positive energies in your body, and it will stop the negative energies being entering into your body. These gemstones, when worn correctly, the finger, it is decided to be worn. Generally, this is the finger where the blue sapphire. And if you wear it on certain days by offering certain kinds of prayers to it, the the effect will be magnified, you know, it will be multiplied. You, even if you don't believe and you just wear it like a piece of a jewelry, it will do its work. But if you have faith and then wear it, then you can see its real power. The gemstones, the zodiac signs, these are not magic. They are just pure science. It's the science, okay? And slowly, like, these things will be taken out from the like tag of superstition, and they are very, very scientific. Even the Western culture believes in it. You know, it's no fashion, it's no theory, it's no superstition. All these things are very, very scientific, and they are related with the well-being of your body and your soul. Okay, so Capricorns, so your lucky gemstone is the blue sapphire, and Capricorns are ruled by the planet Saturn. Let's discuss what kind of traits Capricorns exhibit. Capricorns are, you know, generally very, very responsible. You're persistent, you're logical, you're ambitious, you're very, very adventurous, you're hardworking, and you are very, very goal-oriented. Okay, so these are some general behaviors of Capricorns, and with these kinds of traits, the jobs which you can choose as your career, some of them are: Capricorns can be good accountants, they can be a good like IT staff, you can be into information and technology, you can make great nurse, you can make a great lawyer, administrator, a banker, and a scientist. So these are few jobs from which you can choose. And I always suggest people to choose the job which is also their hobby, so that the pressure of work, the burden of work is, you know, like very, very smooth going, and you don't have that like target meeting and you know, like lazy Sundays and peer pressure and all these things. So make your hobby into your job. And Capricorns, your spirit angel, your spirit guide is Archangel Azrael. Archangel